We are excited at Lakeville Area Schools because our very first array of solar panels is now live on top of Lake Marion Elementary, generating clean, green energy. And this is just the beginning.
So LME is the first of four buildings that are going to get solar panels on the roofs.
I can hardly have words to say how excited I am about this project. I try to teach the kids about the sustainability triangle, how you look at what's good for the planet, what's good for people, and what is economically possible or even profitable. So for me, solar energy is where all those things come together. It's lessening our carbon footprint, it is saving us a lot of money as a school district, and it's helping kids learn.
We work with a company called Ideal Energy to put the solar panels on the roof. It's their responsibility for 20 years. So they pay for the upfront cost, the ongoing cost of any of maintenance, and after the 20 years, then the panels become the district's. So how does the rooftop units work is they collect the sun and the electricity that's generated, the energy that's generated from that goes to Xcel's grid, and then from Xcel's grid they give us a credit back for what we used in our building.
With the way that they're doing these contracts now is that, you know, after 20 years districts get to take over ownership.
School rooftops are great because it doesn't cost extra space. Schools aren't going anywhere, so this tends to be a really great solution.
It's a win-win in the beginning and it's really a win in the end. And we're just excited that we could be one of the first schools to be able to roll this out.
LME is actually not only the first, but it will be the largest payback.
98% of the energy that is produced from these solar panels will support Lake Marion.
Which will leave very little bill left for LME to have to pay. As a district with just the four buildings, we will be saving about $50,000 a year. In year 21, when we actually get all of the credits, the first year alone will be $435,000 credits that we'll be able to go back into our operating budget to assist in other projects.
Well, the project started with one of my STEM teachers, Kim Menard, who approached me about some students who really were passionate about solar energy.
We had been doing a debate unit, and the fifth graders had kind of some assigned topics to pick from. One student said, please, can I do the topic, is the time right for renewable energies to replace fossil fuels? So he so inspired the rest of the class with that debate. We spent a month playing around with solar panels and fountains, and they sent us to the school board.
They had a project ready. They wanted to show the power of solar, and they actually presented to our school board.
So these kids have been pestering me regularly since that time, about 4.5 years ago when they presented, and they are so excited to see this happening now.
This, all of this right here, is driving what's right underneath here. It's fun to tell the kids that the sun is powering our school. And we also have one other symbol. We have a wind turbine and solar light right out by our bus lobby. Every single day they get to see that turbine and they get to see the solar panel and know that that light is strictly getting powered by the sun or by wind. And so like every day the thought of how renewable energy works is in our students, it's in their world.
We want kids to see that what we're teaching them is real and matters and has real life connections. So when my kids are sitting outside this spring doing their solar work, they can look up and see actual solar panels on the roof and see a connection between what they're doing and a real job.
The district now is moving on to their second installation at McGuire Middle School. We have about half the solar panels on the roof already. We're hoping to go live by the end of the year. So after McGuire's installation, we'll be moving right on to North. The last will be JFK Addition, on the addition only. However, in the next couple years, when we replace the roof at JFK, then we'll be able to add additional panels. We have a huge opportunity here with 15 buildings in the district and growing. It's the right thing to do, not only for our own energy savings, but it's also the right thing to be teaching our children so that they can physically see what's going on our roofs and see that we're doing our part to make a difference.
I like that we're walking the walk, and I think whether community members are excited because we are saving money, whether we're lessening our carbon footprint, or whether we're helping promote education, whatever is motivating you, I hope that our community members are equally as excited. And I'm super excited for my solar team of 2017. They get to see that their voices helped get this across and their voices mattered.
We're trying to create legacy that started with an idea from some students, right? And now, you know, you've got something that could be here for 40 years. That's pretty exciting.